The Adams County Together team is here to answer your business questions. Today's question is, how can I create and host an online class?
Hi everybody, Robert Bentley from Legacy Martial Arts right here in Quincy. I wanted to share with you a few ideas that we had on how we got our students to do virtual training during this time where they can't physically come in to train with us. Number one is the Zoom app. Now many of your clients probably already have the Zoom app, whether it's because their kids do virtual training classrooms with their school teachers, or possibly because they just wanted to communicate with their friends from home. If they don't already have the app, it's really easy to download across iOS and Android platforms, and they can get it for free on any device. Now, once you start a meeting, you'll have to choose where you're gonna start it from. And so we have our own personal meeting ID set up that we use our phone number for, so it's easy for our students to remember. And then they can log in for any of our classes that we offer throughout the week. And we post that schedule on our private Facebook group each week so that only they can see it. Now, Zoom also allows you to schedule other meetings. And so we'll use this for our intro classes that we offer to the entire community. So they have their own Zoom ID and log in. We'll use it for staff meetings. And then we can also use it for private lessons. This is great so that our students can see that scheduled out in advance. And we already have it set up ahead of time. Now the first thing we did was a few weeks ago, we had a Zoom meeting just for everybody to log in and just listen to me talk about what our plan was for how we were going to implement classes. We were a little worried about how we could have some tech issues and some things come up. So I'd highly recommend doing this first so that everyone can log in and see how the app works and how to get it to function. And this is a great way to start before you actually implement it into whatever your regular schedule is going to be. Now we did do a couple more technical things like set up lighting and use a webcam and a projector so that we could see our students better. But all you really need is an iPhone or any device that you can shoot from. After that, we were up and running and our students were so excited that they were able to pick up right where they left off. I want to make sure that I can still provide the service for my students that I always have, whether it's virtually or physically training with them. You can get creative as you want, like offering theme days, or we had students wear their favorite sports team jersey to class. And then we even had an Easter egg hunt on Easter weekend where we did Disney Easter eggs that are found within Pixar movies. Our students had an absolute blast with this. Because Zoom makes it so easy for us to record our classes, we're able to upload them to a Vimeo account, and then our students can go back and watch them anytime they want in case they couldn't join our live class or they want to go back and practice the things that we already did. The next area that we've really focused on is our social media. We want to make sure that we can communicate with our students as much as possible. And so we use things like our Facebook page in addition to emails and phone calls and all the other ways that we communicate with our students. As business owners, the more positive that our customers are going to be in, it's important for us to show that and demonstrate that and lead by example. So if you guys have any questions, you can email us, call us anytime. We'd be happy to help run a test run for you on some virtual training or even answer any questions that you might have for social media. We love you. Thank you. We'll see you soon.